Good evening. We have with us Dr. Sanjay Pandey, who is a pioneer in gender assignment surgery, and I am going to speak to him about his experience in India on the surgery, which he's been doing for the last 5 years in Mumbai. Sanjay, welcome to Medindia, and tell us about your, you know, how you started this, you know, got into gender reassignment in the first place in Mumbai.
Thank you so much, sir. Good evening, everybody. It was reconstructive urology, which I learned from you in Chennai, in South India, and when I migrated to Mumbai, had a chance to see so many transgenders operated and were waiting for surgery. When I looked at the subject, because being a reconstructive urologist, it was time to train and take the subject to the next level. I went to Serbia and trained on the subject of males to females and females to males.
And you went to Serbia?
I went to Belgrade University and actually trained in the subject.
Okay.
It gave me...
How long did you spend in Belgrade?
So I spent 3 sessions of 6 weeks each.
Oh, right, okay.
In that cold wintry season, looking at males to females separately and females to males separately.
Okay. And how many surgeries did you watch there?
So, in each session, on average, I saw around 17 to 20 surgeries.
Okay,
17 which were 20. Of various stages around in male to female.
And do they do a lot of these surgeries there?
So, they have a huge European and American population coming to that. One of the largest centers in the world at this point in time. Pioneers since the days of Professor Sava Perovic.
Oh, fantastic. So you did your training there, and then your confidence built up because you already were doing, you know, reconstructive urology. So when you came back, you started off.
So when I came back, the confidence was higher than what I want, because reconstruction and picking up all the good points from there, it helped me to start the first gender clinic in the country, in the city.
Exactly.
Whereby I got
a great service to the humanity, perhaps, I would say.
Yes, the deficiency which we were to fill the gap in the society
right.
of a disease process which is... till that point in time thought as a psychiatric disease,
yes.
which WHO delisted as a psychiatric disease.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yes. In 2016, WHO delisted as a psychiatric disease, depathologized the subject completely.
Oh, really? Okay.
To me, the subject is all about the brain wiring gone wrong.
Absolutely.
And God gave them brains, and when they had...
It is such a good... I mean, it's so important for people out there to listen to you. There's not the person, it is the brain which is, you know, doing things to them.
So the mind and the body are not at congruence. Like right. my body believes that my genitals and my body is same. For them, the mind doesn't accept the body. Now, if you're trying to train the mind towards the body, you're actually forcing, rewarding, coercing. And this is always met with mismatch, suicide, accidents, and has been a failure. The other way around, the cure and the therapy is to bring the body to the mind.
Wow.
Which means that you have to reaffirm the whole subject and give them gender reassignment.
You know, I heard your TED talk, in which you spoke extremely well. And it was, I think you said dysphoria to euphoria. And I think you encapsulated the whole, you know, areas in a very fascinating way. And I think, you know, everyone should watch this once. Tell me, you know, this was done recently. And then we'll come back to your surgical experience.
Professor Shroff, this was a very humbling experience to be invited by TED to speak. And the center closest to me and IES NCRC in Mumbai invited us to give a talk on this very important subject. There were 400 people in this audience. It was important for me to sensitize them on a subject which was never heard of.
Absolutely.
Amidst very amazing talks which were happening around. So I opened it up with a point where a patient actually sadly committed suicide because was forcibly
married. Yes, I heard that. That's a very sad story.
That's a real-time story which goes through in the lives of these individuals because they're forced and the society does not accept it as an entity. We are still a society, we're moving forward. We have moved quite forward on
yes,
the subject.
We
in
have.
A decade of my work and experience on this, I hail India and the society at very high level. We have moved extremely well. But the TED talk was humbling in many ways because I could actually reach the society in many ways.
Absolutely.
I think I could reach those 350 individuals and probably the global audience by doing so.
Fantastic. I think creating that awareness is so very important in this subject, which is not discussed, which is a taboo. It's a taboo, you know, and you know, unfortunately these people suffer.
The stigma of that is huge, and I think India is changing. Now I get calls from Tripura, from Andaman, from Nagarkoil, and from somewhere deep in Bhutan.
I think you're getting referrals from other countries too.
So we have treated people from Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Singapore, and Amsterdam.
Yeah. Amsterdam?
Yes.
Wow. So how many surgeries so far have you done?
So we completed 121 overall,
wow.
males to females and females to males.
Males to females and females to males.
That's right.
So I think the surgery which you do from females to males is more difficult than the other way around, right?
Females
right.
to males is a journey which defies profile. It's
absolutely.
A complex one.
Yeah, absolutely.
To me, I think all these, after psychiatric evaluation and hormonal therapy, and we take them for a surgical exercise under the legal laws of the land, we look at it as a females to males necessarily should be staged. compared to male to female, she's a single stage surgery.
I agree. And you know, do you see the personality change when you know you do these surgeries, when they come back to you and follow up?
Well, sir. So they already have got a great and a very strong personality. Gender dysphoria individuals are extremely strong individuals.
Yes, I know.
Number one. Number two, they have been fighting the hormone which is actually giving them life.
Yeah.
When you reverse the hormone and give them the hormone of journey that they seek, they're already quite a strong personality. When they get that reassignment or they come out of the entrapment of the body that they're entrapped in, I think the confidence is amazing.
Absolutely.
When they recover from the anesthesia, they say, please call me by this name.
Wow.
I'm not Sanjay. I'm Katrina. It feels very good.
And do you have seen some of them getting married?
So yes, both males to females and females to males do have a partner, visible or not visible to me in their interviews and the sessions before. They all plan to get married, not for sex, but to live a life which is more dignified, more out of entrapment, merge with the society much better and more confident.
Right.
Marriages have happened in 30% individuals whom I know. I've attended few marriages. It feels very good and it feels probably complete when you have done the journey for them right from surgery to rehabilitate them back in society.
I think you're doing a great service to the community at large, and we wish you well. Would you want to give any message to your audience?
The message to audience today live, thank you so much, Professor Shroff, to get us connect to everybody live. This is a subject which is hidden in agony and in stigma. India has moved forward in all centers and is glittering now in all the spheres. It is important for us to identify the subject and probably give them the life that they deserve, the right to live and the right to be a dignified person in society.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Sanjay, and wish you the best.